In this video, I will walk through how to add a scope to an aggregated measure in SAS Visual Analytics. I will show how to build the expression and how to determine the intersections for the scope to be applied. I will also show how to use this scoped aggregated measure in other VA objects. Let's get started with the demonstration. I will be using SAS Visual Analytics 2021.1.6 for the hands-on portion of this video, but the same techniques can be used in early releases starting with SAS Visual Analytics 8.2 and later. The first thing we need to do is identify examples of intersections so that we can understand why we would want to add a scope to an aggregated measure. Let's take this simple example. Here I have a crosstab object. Let me go ahead and activate the object and look at the data role assignments. I have date by year assigned to the columns role, facility region assigned to the rows role, and expenses staffing assigned to the measures. It's easy to see that the cells in this crosstab can be identified by the intersection facility region date by year. Let's add a little bit of complexity. On my next tab, let's add the facility to the roles role. This is the crosstab we were looking at before. Now, in this crosstab, when I activate it and look at the data role assignments, we can see I have facility added to the rows role. So now, the cells of the crosstab can be identified with the intersection, facility region, facility, date by year. We still have the same measures here that are summarized in this top crosstab, identified by the intersection facility date by year, that are now highlighted in purple. Facility region date by year are identified as the subtotal cells in this crosstab. In looking at the measure expenses staffing, we can see that the default sum aggregation is being performed at both the cell level and the subtotal level. But for this example, instead of the sum for the subtotal level, but let's say we wanted the average of the expenses staffing for all the facilities in a particular facility region. This is called adding scope to an aggregated measure. Let's toggle over to my slides and take a look at the makeup of an aggregated measure with scope. Here on the left-hand side, we can see the standard aggregated measure. We can see that it has an expression definition, and the default that we spoke about is sum by group of expenses staffing. In our cross tab, we were simply using the default aggregation behavior for this particular data item, but this is the expression we would use to define the aggregated measure. On the right-hand side, we can see that an aggregated measure with scope is a two-part definition. It requires an intersection and then the expression definition. We can see for the base intersection, we will be using the sum by group of expenses staffing. And this expression will be used whenever there is no scope defined for an intersection. For the intersection facility region date by year, which is also the subtotal in our crosstab, we will define the expression to be the average by group of expenses staffing. I have the vertical ellipsis at the bottom there because you can define additional scopes and their intersections with the corresponding expressions for this aggregated measure. Now let's walk through the user interface to show you how you can build this new aggregated measure with scope. I'll be using the data pane, and from the data pane, I will be using the new data item menu and select calculated item. Like in the PowerPoint slide I showed, I will first create the base expression, which is sum by group of expenses staffing. So from the operators tab, I will expand the aggregated symbol and double click on sum to add it to the expression. As soon as I added an aggregated operator to the expression, our scope dropdown becomes available in our expression builder. Toggling to our data items tab, we will be using expenses staffing. Now we have our base scope expression defined. To add a scope to this aggregated measure, we will click on the plus icon, and we will need to define our custom intersection. Remember, our intersection is facility region and date by year. We can choose to start the scope with a blank expression or an existing expression. In this case, let's go ahead and start with the base expression and click OK. Instead of the sum by group of expenses staffing, we wanted to have the average, so I'm going to replace the operator with the average. Now in our expression builder, in our scope dropdown, you can see we have the base expression, which is the sum by group of expenses staffing, and then the scope at facility region date by year, we have the average by group of expenses staffing. Let's go ahead and give this a name. And adjust the format. Okay, let's add it to our crosstab object. Well, we can see this is not the number I was expecting. This is taking, out of all of the detailed data, the average of all of the rows, whereas I really wanted to take the average of the sum of expenses staffing per individual facility region. So we're gonna have to go ahead and edit this, because what I really want is I want the sum of expenses staffing per by group divided by the number of facilities. So let's go ahead and update this to get a better reflection of the number I wanted for this particular intersection. So for our aggregated measure with scope demo that I just created, I'm going to right click and edit. And for the intersection of facility region date by year, I'm going to change this back to sum. And I need the ratio operator. I'm going to divide it by the number of facilities. We're going to get the distinct count of facilities. And click OK. And now this should give me the expected number, which it does. The typical use case for using a scoped aggregated measure is the crosstab object. We can use it in other objects, but you have to make sure that the intersection defined for the scope is met by the object. So let's go ahead and walk through an example. I'm going to duplicate this page. And then I'm going to get rid of this top crosstab that we don't need. And for this crosstab, I'm just going to have it extend. And I'm going to add a bar chart. For the bar chart, I'm going to assign the roles of facility region and our aggregated measure with scope that we just created in the demo. To make it easier to see the values, on the options pane, I'm going to add segment labels and make them bold. So here we can see, I'm also going to make it easier to see which year we're looking at by defining a filter action. So since we were looking at 2009, we can see that the subtotal for East is 525K, and here down here in our bar chart, 525K. But we can see that for the expensive staffing scope demo aggregated measure that we're using, we can see that we only have facility region added to this particular object. In order to actually get the scoped expression, we need to make sure that the intersection is defined. So let me duplicate this bar chart. And remember, our intersection was facility region and date by year. And we don't have date by year added to this object yet. So in the roles tab, I'm going to add a group for date by year. And here we can see that for our aggregated measure with scope, facility region, by date by year, 175K for the East region. And here we're using that expression we defined for this particular scope. What if we wanted to define additional scopes for more advanced intersections? Let's take a look. On the page I have named Advanced Intersections, you can see that this is quite a colorful crosstab object. This is one of the pro tips I want to tell you about. In order to easily identify the intersections, use display rules to easily identify the intersections. When you create a new rule, select any measure in your crosstab and create a criteria where it'll always be true. Here, I happen to know all my values are going to be greater than zero, but you could select an is not missing operator if you wanted to. And then for the specify intersections, go through and create a display rule for each of the individual intersections for your crosstab, and be sure to give it a unique background color. As you can see here, this is what I've done. Now we have been working with the purple highlighted row, which is the subtotal, and we can see that it is indeed identified by the intersection facility region date by year. Our individual cells here at the lowest level is identified by facility region, facility, date by year. Let's take a look at how we can add another scope by using these tips. Let's say we wanted to, for our expenses scope with average, this is what we demonstrated how to do step by step earlier. And here we have the sum, so the base expression when there is no intersection criterion met is to sum expenses staffing. And then at this particular intersection, which is facility region date by year, it's going to take the sum of all of the facilities divided by the number of facilities for expenses staffing. And we want to have that also that same average of the facility expenses to be down here at the total level. And we can see that this pink cell is identified by date by year. So let's go ahead and edit this aggregated measure. So from our data pane, this is called expenses scope with average, which is very exactly what we did with scope demo that we walked through. Right click and edit. The base expression is the sum by group. That's fine. We already have the facility region date by year. Now remember that pink color cell is identified just by date by year. So our custom intersection is going to be date by year. And we want to use the same expression we had for the other intersection. So we're going to go ahead and start the expression with what we used for the previous scope for facility region date by year. And then we're going to click OK. And now you can see it's updated. So that's all we needed to do is we needed to add another scope for this aggregated measure. And it just happens to be the same one that we were using for a different intersection. Let's do another, not a tricky one, but just to show that we can. Over here on the gray level, we can see that's grand total. Obviously, you can see how we moved all of these different intersections to build our custom intersections. But what about this gray? It just says grand total. How are we going to build out that scope for grand total? So let's go ahead and right click on our aggregated measure with scope again. And we're going to add another scope. And we can see I don't have any grand total here. But up at the top, when it says to specify scope, it says you can either define a custom intersection or this is where a grand total comes into play. And for a grand total, we're just gonna say have it return a dollar, just to make it pretty clear that we can change its value. So I'm just gonna have it to return $1. Click OK, and now we can see for the grand total for this aggregated measure, it's going to be returning the expression I said for this particular grand total intersection, which was $1. As an example, I wanted to show you with these two columns, it's a combination of a few things. So in this first column, you can see that I've determined the percent of column subtotal because we can see that all of the individual blue cells add up to 100. And then at the subtotal level, we have those percent of column values there. But the requirement that came through was they want to see the percent of total at the individual blue cell, but at the subtotal level, they want to see the actual value. Same thing at the total level. So one thing I want to point out is you can see that we cannot mix and match formats. So the best thing you can do is just to select a basic numeric format with decimal precision that meets both of the needs. But let's take a look at how we would define this aggregated measure. So from the data pane, this is expenses scope with percent of column total. So down here, we're going to go ahead and edit. And we can see our base expression is the sum by group of expenses staffing. And then the other scope we have is for facility region, facility date by year. And this is where we're using that percent of total. And we can see that some people might think that the blue always follows the base expression. Remember, the base expression in this one is the sum by group of expenses staffing. So again, the base expression is going to be used whenever there is no scope defined for an intersection. And this particular aggregated measure had an intersection definition for facility region, facility date by year, which was the percent of column total. And all of the other cells where there's no scope defined is going to use that sum of expenses staffing, which is how that we get that at all of the other cells. For more information, please refer to the SAS Visual Analytics documentation or check out one of these blogs. Thank you, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.